Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In this tutorial, I'm going to explain about the sign convention and as well as the power of lens. As because these two concepts are very near, and this is the serial classes that I'm uploading since the first lecture of the refraction of light. And you know that a lens is a part of that. So when I uploaded the first class of lens, then I explained what are the main concept and the definitions of lens. So if you understand that what is the ray diagram of the lens, then it would be more easier for us to understand the sign of the sign convention and the power of lens. What is the power of lens? If I say one line, then you can say that the power of, or the capability of, or the capacity of a lens to make a parallel ray diagram into convergent or a divergent beam of light or divergent rays, that capacity is called the power of a lens. So if I ask you a very first question, that if you see these two figures, suppose this is figure A and figure B, so if the question is which lens has more power, then what would be the answer? So apparently you say that this point is the principal focus. So this point is also a principal focus. And in this case, this is concave lens, and here this is also a principal focus. So if I ask you that between these pictures, these two pictures, picture A and B, which lens has more power, then your answer should be A lens. Why? Okay, I'm coming up with this explanations. Before we explain these, you see that this is a convex lens. Both are convex lens, but apparently we can see that from this optical center, the distance is the focal length. So the focal length of A lens and the focal length of B lens, if you see, then you find, if I say this is the focal length of A and this is the focal length of B, we can see that focal length of B is greater than the focal length of A. That means the focal distance is greater in B lens, and that is why the power of B lens is comparatively less than lens A. Why? Because we know the equation is very importantly that P is equal 1 by F, and this is the equation that we need to use. The power of a lens, that P is equal 1 by F. That means that the shorter of a focal length of any lens is greater its power. That means this focal length is inversely proportional to the power of the lens. That means if I say that this focal length is suppose 20 centimeter. So if I say this is 20 centimeter and I say that this is a 60 centimeter, suppose. So now the question is, if I know the focal length of any lens, then how can I can find out the power of that lens? So we need to know that P is equal 1 by F, but this F, this focal length, should be in meter. Should be in meter. So 20 centimeter is 0.2 meter and 60 centimeter is 0.6 meter. So now if I want to find the power of lens A, then we got that P is equal to 1 by 0.2, and then the power of lens B, we got that the focal length is 1 by 0.6. Now you see that if I use a calculator, then this would be an easier for us to find it out, that 1 divided by 0.2, which is 5, which is 5, and in case of power of lens B, 1 by 0.6, which is 1.67. See, 1.67. Now, what is the unit of power of lens? The unit of power of lens is diopter. You must know the word is diopter, and it is expressed by small d. So this d, it means this is the power of lens. So we say that 5 diopter were 1.67 diopter. So if you know that the focal length should be in meter, that means if you know the focal length of any lens, you can find out the power of that lens. So very simply, we must remember one thing: the shorter of focal length, the greater of its power. So the greater of focal length, the shorter of power. So that means that comparatively, those lens has short length of focal length, they have more power. That means this lens has more capacity to make the parallel beam into a convergent. So we know this convex lens is known as convergent or converging lens, and this concave lens is known as diverging lens. That means it's diverging the rays, and it's virtually is optimizing here, so the focal length is in that side where light is coming. So that is why while I'll talk about the sign convention, things will be much more clear. So I hope you understand what is power of lens. So the capacity of a lens to make it convert or a divergent into this parallel beam of light, that is known as the power of a lens. And the shorter focal length, the greater power of lens. Now think about the sign convention. If I think about it, that what is sign convention? What is about the positivity and negativity? You see, there are two types of process to understand the sign convention. Number one is a real positive convention, and the second is a new Cartesian convention. In this video, I'm going to explain about the real positive convention. What is this? When the parallel beam of light is converging actually, that means they are actually converging in a principal focus. So this is the real distance. So when a light rays is passing through and traversing the real distance, this distance is known as positive. This distance will be expressed as positive. But in case of concave lens, you see that they are diverging from the lens. So they are actually accumulating and they are meeting into the other side of the lens. So this distance will be measured as negative. So this would be negative. So if I can quote from the books, then what are the conventions in case of real positive conventions? Number one, all distance are to be measured starting from the optical center of a lens. That means we are measuring every single distance from this point, this optical point. So if suppose this is the convex lens, so we are measuring distance from that side, which is the real distance. So we are measuring it, it's positive. And when in case of concave lens, it's not actual distance covered by the ray, it's the appearing from this point. So this is actually virtual. So all the virtual length would be negative. So I'm quoting from book again. Number two is all real distance are positive, and the real distance means the distance actually covered by the ray. In other words, distance of real object, distance of real image, and distance of real focus are all taken to be positive. Actually, in case of convex lens, all the distance are positive. In case of concave lens, all virtual distances are negative. The distance which is not actually covered by the ray, but it appears that ray has covered that distance in a virtual distance. Distance of virtual object, distance of virtual image, and distance of virtual focus are all taken to be virtual distance. So we know this is the virtual distance, and this would be negative. Positive, negative, positive, and negative. because this is virtual. They are appearing that this is the cover by the ray, but this is not the actual distance covered by the rays. So positive would be in case of convex, negative would be in case of concave. Now think about, if the question is that a person is using a spectacles about a 5 diopter. So the question is that this is 5 diopter. He is using a spectacles which power is plus 5 diopter. What are the nature of that lens and what is the focal distance of this lens? If this is the questions, then you see that this is power is given. So the power of a lens is given. The question is, what is the focal distance of that lens? So we know that P equal 1 by F in meter. It should be in meter. So now I need to find the focal distance in meter. So I say 1 by 5. So if it is 1 by 5, this is actually 0.2 meter. So if it is 0.2 meter, we can say that the focal distance is 0.2 meter or 20 centimeter. In your question paper, if any MCQ or multiple choice questions are to be arrived, regarding these, we need to think about the unit. This is very, very important. Think about the unit. Is it meter or centimeter? Even the question is that if somebody is using minus 2.5D, power is minus 2.5D. So you see that here, this 20 centimeter is the focal length when the power is 5D, and this is plus. So this focal distance is 20 centimeter and this is a convex lens. But you think about this one, it's a minus given, so this is simply, we know this is concave lens and it's all about this. So if you use this one, that P is equal 1 by F, so the power is given, we need to find out the focus, that 1 by P, which is 1 by 2.5. So what is the value of 1 by 2.5, which is 0.4 meter. So this would be 0.4 meter or 40 centimeter. But this is minus was given. So this minus 40 centimeter means this is the virtual distance covered by the ray, and it's all about possible in case of concave lens, not in convex lens. So when you see the positive sign is given, this is convex. When you see the negative sign is given, this is concave, because it's a virtual distance covered by the ray. It was not actually meeting in the other part in principal axis. So this is a virtual distance and all virtual distance are negative. I hope you understand. It's a very simple formula, which is P equal 1 by F, but this is to be remembered that this F is meter. I mean, this F will be measured in meter, but you can express it into centimeter also, just multiplying into 100. So positive in case of convex, negative in case of concave. And the shorter of a focal length, the greater its power of the lens. So it means that shorter focal length means this lens has more capability or more capacity to make the convergent ray or the divergent ray. So this can be both applicable in case of convex and concave. And when we will think about the vision effects of human, we know that those people has visual effect and differs in their eyes, that hypermetropia and myopia. In this case, we will know that the myopia patient will use this concave lens and hypermetropia patient will use the convex lens, because it's very interesting. If you understand the process, then myopia and hypermetropia will be much more easier for us to understand it. So I'm coming up with that topic. So stay tuned with me and do let me know your recommendations and feedback in the comment sections. So take care, stay well, bye.